In today's class, we will see about the natural vegetation. In the previous class, we saw about the soil and its type, and also what type of crops are cultivated in each type of soil. These cultivated crops and fruits form a part of vegetation, but it is not a natural vegetation. The cultivation of crops takes place with the help of human support, but natural vegetation occurs naturally. We will now see in detail what is meant by natural vegetation. Natural vegetation refers to a plant community which has grown naturally without any human support. We have seen forest with many large trees. Have you seen any human planting or sowing seeds in forest or watering the trees in the forest? No, we have not seen that. These trees grow naturally under the climatic condition, depending on the climatic condition in that region. This is called as natural vegetation. The plant community which has grown naturally without any human support is referred to as natural vegetation. Natural vegetation is also referred to as forest cover. All the forests do not have the same varieties of plants and trees. They differ according to the landform, nature of soil, temperature, and rainfall. These are the factors which controls the distribution of natural vegetation. As per National Forest Policy 1988, a minimum of 1/3 of the total geographical area must be under forest cover. That is, consider the state Tamil Nadu. In that total area of Tamil Nadu, 1/3 of the area must be a forest. That is, about 33% of the state must be a forest. But according to Tamil Nadu State of Forest Report 2017, this report says that the area under forest in the state of Tamil Nadu is 26,281 square kilometer. That is, it is about only 20.21% of the total area. So therefore, the total forest cover of Tamil Nadu is very lower or very less. When considering the forest cover of India, Tamil Nadu constitutes 2.99% of the total India's forest cover. So in total India, Tamil Nadu constitutes only 2.99%. The Western Ghats are the longest hill range in the state and is one of the 25 global hotspots of biodiversity. Hotspots of biodiversity means the region that are both logically, biologically fertile. That is, they are rich in distribution of plants and animals, and also at the same time they are highly in danger. So Western Ghats is one of the 25 global hotspots of biodiversity, and also these Western Ghats are one of the 3 mega centers of endemism in India. Endemism means the animals or plants in that region lives only in that particular location. Next comes the categories of forest. The following table shows the categories of forest and their aerial extent classified under the provision of Indian Forest Act. First is the reserved forest. These reserved forests are highly protected by the government. And next comes the protected forest. These type of forests are also protected by the government, but special permissions are given for all type of activities unless it is prohibited. Third comes the unclassified forest. Those forests which do not come under the protection of government is called as unclassified forest. So the total forest area in Tamil Nadu is about 22,507 square kilometer. The forest in the state is broadly divided into five types, namely tropical evergreen forest, which means in Tamil Pasumai Mara Kadugal. Second one is the mountain temperate forest. Third is the tropical deciduous forest. Fourth, mangrove forest. And the last is the tropical thorn forest. We will see about each type in detail. Forest type. The forest in the state is broadly divided into five types. The first comes the tropical evergreen forest. Evergreen means the tree, the leaves of the tree are evergreen throughout the year because they do not shed their leaves during any season. These type of forests are found in the region that receive heavy rainfall. The average rainfall in these forests is more than 200 centimeters. It is a dense multi-layered forest. Multi-layered means you can see trees, shrubs and creepers, that is from bottom to top at various heights. You can see all type of plant varieties, so it is called as a multi-layered forest. This region is warm and wet throughout the year. You can find these tropical evergreen forest in the upper slopes of Western Ghats of Tirunelveli, Kanyakumari, Nilgiris and Coimbatore districts. The major tree species of this forest are cinnamon, Malabar ironwood, panasa, Java plum or jamun, jack, kindle, avani and grape myrtle. Semi-evergreen forest are a combination of both evergreen and deciduous forest. You can see both varieties of trees in this forest. These semi-evergreen forests are found in the hills of Eastern Ghats, especially in the hills of Servarayan, Kollimalai and Pachimalai hills. Species of Indian mahogany, monkey teak, woolly cassia, jack and mango trees are common in this region. Mountain temperate forest. They are called as Mitha Veppa Mandala Kadugal in Tamil. These mountain temperate forests are found in the sheltered valleys of Anamalai, Nilgiris and Palani hills over a 1000 meters altitude. We already know what is a valley. Valley is a land between two hills or a mountain. So the land area between two mountains or hills is called as a valley. Tamil la pallathaakum solvu. So in the valley la irukkira and the forest da nama mountain temperate forest appdin solrom. The forest in the found in the sheltered valleys of Anamalai, Nilgiris and Palani hills are called as the mountain temperate forest. They are also known as sholas. The trees in this forest are evergreen but usually short. In the tropical evergreen forest, the trees are very tall. Here in the mountain temperate forest, the trees are short. Some of the trees which are found commonly are Nilgiri Champa, Vetch Litsi, and rose apple. The third type of forest is the tropical deciduous forest. Deciduous means இலையுதிர் காடுகள். This type of forest lies in the border of semi-evergreen and tropical evergreen forest. The trees in this forest shed their leaves during the dry season, that is during the summer season. The trees in these forests shed their leaves. The leaves fall down. The trees grow up to a maximum height of 30 meters. Some trees of this forest are silk cotton, kapok, kadamba, dog teak, woman's tongue, axle wood, and ceres. Bamboos are also common in this type of forest. Some trees of this forest are economically important. Mangrove forest. Mangrove forests are commonly found in Pichavaram. This type of forest is found in the coastal areas, river deltas, and tails of islands. Since the trees of the mangrove forest grows well in the salt water, they are found along the coastal region. அதாவது கடலும் நிலமும் சந்திக்கிற இடத்துல you can find these mangrove forests in common. The vegetation is typical evergreen. That means the trees do not shed their leaves at any season. The trees are medium in height and has leathery leaves. The leaves are very flexible. The vegetation of this forest is adapted to survive in tidal mud and salt water. So the trees grow well in salt water. Asiatic mangrove, white mangrove, wild jasmine, Indian peewit are some of the notable trees of this forest. Pichavaram, Vedaranyam, Muthuppet, Chatram and Thoothukudi are the places in Tamil Nadu where the mangrove forest is found to a considerable extent. And role of mangroves in coastal zone management. Mangroves helps in prevention of coastal erosion from waves and storms. That is, the mangroves acts as a barrier and prevents the waves and storms from eroding the coastal region. It also protects coral reefs and seagrass. Coral reefs are pavala paaraigal. It protects the coral reefs and seagrass. Pichavaram mangrove forest is located near Chidambaram in Kadalur district. It is the second largest mangrove forest in the world. It covers an area of about 11 square kilometers. It is separated from the Bay of Bengal by sandbar. It consists of species like Avicennia and Rhizophora. It also supports the existence of rare varieties of shell and fin fishes. In this tabular column, you can see the name of districts with prominent forest cover in Tamil Nadu. So, the district which has the maximum forest cover in Tamil Nadu is Dharmapuri with an area of 3280 square kilometer. Next to Dharmapuri is Coimbatore. And third one is Erode, fourth is Vellore, and then Nilgiris and Dindigul. Tropical thorn forest. Thorn forest in Tamil Nadu is found where there is a little rainfall. These forests are found from plains up to 400 meters altitude. The common trees of this forest are rusty acacia, wheel, neem and palm. Neem and palm you know already. So the other types of trees are called as karuvela maram in Tamil. These karuvela maram are called as the curse of Tamil Nadu because it makes the region dry. Wherever it goes, it makes that region dry. Because the roots of these tree grows long and deep into the soil and it absorbs the surface water. On the other side, the leaves of this tree are thick and has large pores. Therefore, it absorbs the moisture content in the air. If the air loses its moisture content, then there will be no chance of rain. There will be no rainfall in that region. The root absorbs the surface water and the leaves absorbs the moisture content in the air. So therefore, the region becomes totally dry. So therefore, it is called as the curse of Tamil Nadu. Government of Tamil Nadu is taking lots of measures to destroy this tree. This type of forest is found in the districts of Dharmapuri, Ramanathapuram, Virudhunagar and some parts of interior districts. You can see this tree karuvela maram commonly in all the places, but it is found in vast in Dharmapuri, Ramanathapuram and Virudhunagar districts. Answer the following questions. Distinguish between the following. You can answer the third question. What is the difference between the tropical evergreen forest and tropical deciduous forest?